We are loving winter fun at Pando Winter Sports Park right here in West Michigan. You know, you got to think about all aspects of safety when it comes to our families having fun in the winter. We brought in our expert, Michael McLear from Escape Fire Safety. Michael, talk to me about some of the things you see families kind of not remembering very often.
Well, it's been a traditional Michigan winter, and sometimes we get complacent and we forget about ice may not be safe on ponds, rivers, and streams. So let's talk about some things that can keep our families safe. A lot of times we think the ice is safe just by looking at it.
But or we say, man, it's been cold for a while, let's head out.
Absolutely, but we've also had a lot of snow, and snow acts as a blanket and an insulator on that ice. So we need to make sure our ice is thick enough. We're gonna have great content on WOTVforWomen.com. We want to make sure, again, families never go after toys or pets.
So if Jake the fire dog runs out on the ice, I shouldn't chase after him?
Not at all, because it may be safe. He's much lighter than we are, and if that ice is weak, we could fall in.
How can you tell if you can go out on the ice?
Well, we want to make sure, again, the ice is at least 6 inches thick and in uniform thickness. Ice can vary in its thickness because of underwater streams, because of sunny days, because of warm temperatures, and we've had some of those recently. So the ice can change from day to day, but even extreme cold temperatures can cause ice to crack and make it not safe. So we have to be careful of that.
So the rule of thumb, stay off the ice.
Exactly. The only safe ice is at an ice skating rink.
Perfect.
So that's a good tip to remember. If the ice does start to crack, it's important that we lay down and distribute our weight. That's a better choice. And again, if someone has fallen through the ice, immediately call 911 and make sure that the trained rescuers arrive.
You guys train for this. You are prepared for it. I want to take a look at the suit. Talk to me about how you wear this, when you wear it.
We have our ice and cold water safety suit. It's similar to our regular personal protective equipment that we use for firefighting, but this is specifically for ice and cold water. It helps keep us buoyant to let us float, but it keeps us warm and dry so we can go out onto the ice in teams with ropes and proper training and hopefully get somebody out of the ice as quickly as possible.
So if a friend falls through the ice, do you throw a branch to them? Do you go out and lay on the, you know, what are we supposed to do?
If a branch is close by and you can throw it or a rope, that's certainly a good choice until 911 arrives, but make sure we stay on the land and on the shore. And actually, I've got a great exercise here that we can focus on.
I'm a little nervous that we have a bowl of ice out here in the cold weather. What are you thinking here, Michael?
Well, what we're going to do, and we're going to have this tip for teachers and firefighters on WOTVforWomen.com. Let's put our hands in this ice.
Why? Why do you want me to do this?
And we've got ice cold water. This is going to simulate the effects of cold and chilling on the body. And as a teacher, we talk about developing our fine motor skills for our individuals. So what we're going to do is after we actually pick up or take our hand out of this ice, we're going to see how difficult it is to pick up a penny.
Okay.
Or something.
I'm ready to get my hand out of the ice.
Absolutely,
how about you?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So let's try and pick up this penny that we have right here.
Oh, yeah. It's not working real well.
And it's actually very difficult.
Uh-huh.
And for our
Why?
Older students,
why can't I pick up a penny?
Absolutely. Again, our capillaries, the extremities freeze first. Hypothermia and frostbite really sets in. And for our older students, we could actually have them write their name on a dry erase board. Again, trying to grab that pen is very, very difficult. So this is something that the family can do together to demonstrate the effects of cold water on the body. And it's not just in the wintertime. It's in the summertime as well. Cold water is typically anything less than 98.6 degrees, our normal body temperature.
So this is a good example of to show your kids that when you take a chance on the ice, this is what you're looking at.
That's right. That's right.
Wow.
And it makes our body not respond to our commands. So it's important for us to remember, we may think we can get out of the ice, but our body won't let us get out once it gets cold.
Excellent. Michael McLear, you always do a fabulous job.
Thank you,
Thanks for keeping us safe.
Absolutely.